Coverage. Of course, Kathy Orr and Scott Williams are busy tracking the storm. Jennifer Joyce and Chris O'Connell are out in the elements, literally. Let's begin with Kathy Orr, live outside our Old City studios, where it is coming down, Kath.
It is. It's just like deja vu. Didn't we do this last night, Lucy? It's the same thing. It's the same time and the same place. You can see on Market Street right now, we don't have anything snow covered just yet. But it is coming down. It's starting to stick on untreated surfaces, and it will be sticking overnight as temperatures get colder. Take a live look from our cam atop our studios, and you can see the full view, and it's looking wet here. That's just about it right now. Here is your ultimate Doppler. You can see the band of snow moving in, but look at all that green. That's all the warm air that's going to push through during the morning hours tomorrow. But for now, the story is the snow, and it's going to continue to stick overnight tonight. In the purple. That includes Philadelphia, I-95 corridor, south and east. That's a winter weather advisory for light snow, and that will change to rain. But the pink area, our northern western suburbs, into the Lehigh Valley and the Poconos, that is a warning where we do expect more snow and potential icing. Accumulations, well, to the north and west of the city, 3 to 6 inches of snow and potential for ice in the Lehigh Valley, about 1 to 3 along the I-95 corridor, and as you head through South Jersey, just about a coating to an inch where you will see a mix and then a quick changeover to rain. We'll talk more about who gets what and also the winds and icing associated with this storm coming up later in the broadcast. But for now, Lucy, I've got to get the snow out of my eyelashes.
Yes, yes, you do. And come on inside, Kath. And so here we are. The snow moved in and then stopped, and then the streets cleared, and now another round is moving on in, meaning crews will have to clean the streets all over again. Here is the parkway right now. And, you know, it's not too bad. All of it is changing, though. So let's get on out to Fox 29's Jennifer Joyce, live in King of Prussia, Montgomery County. So, Jennifer, basically it's go time for road crews.
Yes, it is, Lucy. So it has been snowing here in King of Prussia for the last couple of hours, but take a look at the roads. While Route 202 here is wet, the snow is not yet sticking. Regardless, PennDOT crews have been out and about tonight. We also met a number of people out preparing for this storm.
Trying to get ready for that more snow that's coming.
We caught Deirdre McDonald of Wayne making a salt run tonight.
I'm hearing it's going to be double trouble, so what I'm trying to do is get prepared.
She says things were a little shaky at her house this morning. Her salt supply was low, and she was not taking any chances with storm number two.
One thing I don't want to do is slip and fall.
Like McDonald, PennDOT is staying ahead of the storm. Our cameras captured crews loading their salt trucks in Norristown hours before the first flakes began to fall. Drivers like Tiffany Finney also taking the proactive approach, filling up her tires. How do you do driving in bad weather?
I don't, actually. This is a very small car, and I will spin out, so I go home.
I think it's about leaving early. You know, you leave early, you drive safe.
Zach Posha of Norristown says he's careful in bad weather, but also confident because his four-wheel drive SUV also has 4 snow tires.
It grips the road better. Managing for snow. Snow doesn't build up on the tires, so it's a lot easier to navigate through.
Around here, a couple of inches can lead to serious issues. Kurt Howell, the owner of Christian Snowblowing, sees it firsthand.
Around here, it's very hilly, so 1 inch is almost the same as 9 inches.
For that reason, PennDOT is warning people.
Take your time, be careful. We tend to see a lot of spinouts on the on-ramps and the off-ramps on the interstates.
And if you're lucky, perhaps you can stay home tomorrow. Maybe you'll have the option to work from home like our friend Tiffany. Is that like a sigh of relief, knowing that you don't have to venture out in the snow?
Oh, absolutely. I don't even want to deal with it. So it's actually nice to have the option.
Working from home is a beautiful thing in this kind of weather. Lucy, I don't think our boss is going to go for it, but that's okay. We actually, sometimes we do enjoy this kind of coverage. It's important for us to be out here to obviously let everybody at home know what's going on the roads.
Absolutely.